गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम केवी भिक्षमैया, लेक्चर इन जुआलॉजी, गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज, गंभीरावपेट, राजन सिरसिल्ल। ओके, सब्जेक्ट जुआलॉजी। टुडे टॉपिक इज रैबिट हैबिटेट एंड हैबिट्स एंड डाइजेशन सिस्टम। रैबिट फाइलम कॉर्डेटा, सब फाइलम वर्टिब्रेटा, क्लास ममेलिया, सब क्लास इथीरिया, ऑर्डर लागोमॉर्फिया, जीनस अरिक्लोटोलागस, स्पीसीज क्यूनिक्यूलस। रैबिट्स आर ग्रिगेरियस एनिमल्स, जनरली कर्सोरियल, sometimes saltatorian in locomotion and lead pastoral life. These are crepuscular animal which are active during dawn and dusk. Young rabbits are known by the name bunny. Male is buck and female is doe. Rabbits are herbivorous animals. They are in the habit of feeding on their own feces and hence they are described as caprophagous animals. Habitat and habits. Rabbits live in forests, grasslands, fields, etc. They live in burrows. The burrows are in like spicules, tunnels which are interconnected and form an intricate net called a warren. Warren has many openings to outside. Rabbits and their young ones take a shelter in the warren and are thus protected from their enemies. Rabbits are the polygamous. One male mates with many females. Lifespan of rabbits is 13 years. The gestation period is 31 days. Each time a rabbit gives birth to 5 to 8 young ones. External features. Rabbit is about 40 cm. Rabbit is about 40 centimeters long and wide, about 750 grams to 1600 grams. Body of rabbit is covered by dense, soft fur. Body of rabbit is divisible into head, neck, trunk and tail. Next, head of rabbit is large and fear shaped. Anteriorly it is produced into a shout. A transverse slit like mouth is present below the snout. It is bounded by movable muscular lips. Upper lips has a clipped and hence it is called hair lip. Through the slit, incisors are visible. On either side of the upper lips are long, stiff, practically hairs called vibrissae or whiskers. A pair of large eyes is present, one on either side of the head, behind the eyes and on the posteriorly parts of the head. A pair of large spout shaped movable ear lobes, that's called pineum, is present, one on either side. Pinna can be moved independently and collect sound waves from all directions. Next, we discuss about neck. Head and trunk are connected by a short neck. Next, trunk. Trunk of rabbit is large and is distinguished into the two parts, namely anterior thorax and posterior abdomen. Thorax encloses the heart and lungs, which are protected by the bony rib cage. Abdomen encloses viscera. The internally thorax and the abdomen are separated by diamond shaped muscular membrane called diaphragm. On the ventral side, abdomen has 4 to 5 pairs of nipples or tits. The trunk bears 2 pairs of limbs, namely forelimbs and end limbs. Forelimbs are shorter than end limbs. Rabbit digits. Rabbit digs the burrow with the help of claws of forelimb. End limbs are mainly used for leaping. Next, tail. The tail is short and bushy and is located at the posterior end of the trunk. It has a white patch on the lower side. In case of danger, it is used as a warning signal to the other members of the group. This is the rabbit habitat and habits, and also we discuss about external features. External features, as body of the rabbit is divisible into head, neck, trunk and tail. Next, we discuss rabbit digestive system. Rabbit digestive system. This is the most important in the examination point of view. The digestion system of rabbit consists of two components, namely eliminatory canal and digestive glands. One is the alimentary canal and two is the digestive glands. First we discuss alimentary canal. As rabbit is a herbivore, it is alimentary canal is very long and coiled. It begins with mouth and ends with anus. It includes mouth, vestibule, buccal cavity, pharynx, pharyngeus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine and anus. First, mouth. The alimentary canal starts from the mouth. It is bounded by two lips, an upper lip and lower lip. The upper lip is divided by a vertical clipped extending up to nostrils. Through this clipped the incisors, the exposed. This type of lips is called hair lip. Hair lip helps gnawing. Next, vestibule. Small cavity present between lips, cheeks and gums of teeth is called vestibule. Mouth leads into a buccal cavity through vestibule. Next, buccal cavity. The buccal cavity bounded above by the palate and on the side by jaws and the floor of the buccal cavity contains a tongue, palate. That is the roof of the buccal cavity. It remains as a longitudinal partition between food passage and nasal chamber. The anterior part of the palate is called alveolate. It is internally supported by the palatine process of premaxilla, maxilla and palatine. The lower surface of the hard palate bears prominent transverser ridges called palatine rugae. The posterior part of the heart plated is soft called soft plate. The soft plate is formed by connective tissue and it hangs down into the pharynx as uvula. Next, jaws. Both jaws of the rabbit process the podont, heterodont and diplodont teeth. Rabbit has three types of teeth, namely incisors, premolars and molars. Components of the absent. There remains a gap between incisors and premolars in the upper jaw and lower jaw. This gap is called diastema. Diastema is due to the absence of cornices. In rabbit, there is a total number of 28 teeth. In rabbit, there is a total number of 28 teeth. Dental formula of rabbit. 2033/1023. Next, tongue. The floor of the buccal cavity is occupied by muscular tongue. It is attached by most part of the posterior end and the anterior end is free. On the upper surface of the tongue, there are four types of papillae which contains taste buds. They are fungiform papillae, fuliform papillae, circumotillate papillae, fuliati papillae. The tongue many phyllites and food. It mixes the food with saliva. The buccal cavity leads into the pharynx. Pharynx lies behind the soft plate. The pharynx can be divided into three regions, namely nasopharynx, oropharynx, laryngopharynx. It opens into the oesophagus through slight like opening called gullet. Oesophagus. It is a long, narrow and muscular tube. It passes through the neck and in the thorax. It passes the diaphragm and reaches the abdomen. It is serves to convey the food from pharynx into the stomach. Next, stomach. The stomach lies on the left side of the anterior part of the abdominal cavity. The stomach is divisible into three parts, namely cardiac stomach, pandic stomach, and pyloric stomach. The oesophagus opens into the cardiac stomach through cardiac aperture. It is guarded by a valve called cardiac sphincter. This prevents the passage of the food back into the oesophagus. Next, the pyloric stomach opens into the small intestine by a opening called pylorus and is guarded by a valve called pyloric sphincter. Pyloric sphincter regulates the flow of food into the duodenum. Into the duodenum. Next, fundic stomach is the biggest part. Fundic stomach is the biggest part and lies between cardiac and pyloric part of stomach. The stomach leads into the duodenum of the small intestine. Next we discuss small intestine. Is a narrow coil tube for the about 2.5 centimeters long. And it is divisible into two parts, namely duodenum and ileum. The anterior part of the small intestine called the duodenum. It is U-shaped. It has a descending limbs and ascending limb. The descending limb receives the bile duct and the ascending limbs receives as pancreatic duct. The duodenum leads to into the ileum. The posterior part of the small intestine is called a ileum. It is very long and greatly coiled. The internal lining of ileum is raised into the numerous finger-like process called a villi. Villi increase the surface area of the intestine. The terminal part of the ileum is enlarged into a bulb-like structure called sulcus rotundus. The terminal part of the ileum is enlarged into the bulb-like structure called sulcus rotundus. Ileum is the thin walled sacs. It is located between the small intestine and large intestine. It has a spiral valve inside. The spiral valve is the externally marked by spiral constructions. Ileum ends with the appendix. The ileum is an helicoidal valve which is the direction to the food into the ileums. Ileum contains the symbiotic bacteria that help in the cellulose digestion. Large intestine. The small intestine opens into the large intestine. It is about 1 meter long. It consists of two regions, namely colon and rectum. Anterior part of the large intestine is called colon. The colon bears longitudinal muscular bonds called the tinea along its the mid dorsal line. Inner part of the colon has a series of the constrictions, which form pouches called the ostra. The colon leads into the rectum. It is so beats aperture in due to the presence of fecal fillets. Next, anus. The rectum opens into the outside by the anus. It is situated at the base of the child. Anus is guarded by an anal sphincter. This is the only rabbit digestion system of alimentary canal. Tomorrow we discuss about this digestive glands and process of the digestion of in a rabbit. Okay, thank you.